is it? Who is it?
Police officer.
Ruby Anderson?
Yes, sir. Come in.
You reported a prowler, I believe?
Yes, somebody tried to get in that door.
Did you actually see anyone?
No, I couldn't get a look at him. He was in the dark at the top of the stairs.
I'll take a look. You wait here. This will only take a second. There now. Probably saw me and ducked down the stairs. You sure he tried to break in?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, otherwise, when he would have identified himself when he knocked and when I opened the door.
Can you give me identification?
Well, he was medium, height, dark. I don't know, I didn't get a good look. He was in the shadows.
What was he wearing?
Sport coat, raincoat, I don't know. I didn't really get a look at him.
But you're positive you've never seen him before?
Oh, absolutely. There was nothing familiar about him. And then a lot of crazy things have been going on around here. Strange telephone calls, pipes, radios blaring in the street.
All right, I'll make a report and alert the cop on duty. You just take care of yourself. If that was a burglar, he was scared away because he found somebody in here. I don't think you'll have any more problems. You lock this behind me, would you?
Oh, yes, indeed, officer. Thank you very much.
Haunted Star, Blackie Parrish speaking.
Oh, hi, Blackie. It's Ruby. Is Robert there?
No, he's not. Him and Tiffany went to the bank.
Look, when he gets back, will you tell him on my way over, and it's urgent that I talk to him?
Yeah, no problem.
Okay, thanks.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
As the medical conventions go, it was very nice. I was very pleased with the reaction to my speech.
I always liked your speeches.
Oh, well, you're prejudiced. You know, I had an interesting meeting with Laura Templeton this morning. Monica suggested that she come and see me. She's a very mixed up girl.
Monica or Laura?
Laura. Oh, well, I understand the confusion, yes. How are you? How was your morning?
Well, it was hectic as usual. No more hectic than usual. Had a call from father and son Quartermains.
Not the best way to start your day.
Nor to spend a lunch. Something about a big surprise for me.
Oh, I wonder if there could be a connection.
To what?
Well, while I was talking to Laura this morning, Monica popped her head in my office, and she seemed very intense. And I just wonder if Monica's mixed up with this surprise that Edward...
I think we're going to find out. Here they come right now.
Excuse me.
Hello, Baldwin.
Are we intruding?
No, not at all.
I'm terribly sorry to barge in like this, but I must tell you something. There is not going to be any divorce.
No, Alan and Monica spent the night together in her bedroom. He even has a witness. Dear Stella happened to pop in on them.
Duly shocked, I suppose.
Flabbergasted.
Well, Alan, I don't quite understand all the legal ramifications, but I think it's just great. I always thought that you and Monica would get back together again.
Wait a minute, Gail. This is strictly business.
Well, yeah, just a Quartermain doing his duty for home and family. Alan really deserves a silver star for this one.
You're a little quietly. I mean, we have ruined the divorce, haven't we?
Oh, yes. Okay. You have ruined it, and you got in just under the wire. The court date's Wednesday.
Was Wednesday, but you can cancel that now, of course. Correct?
Well, I'm sure Monica's lawyer won't desire to proceed at this juncture. I'll talk to him first, Court.
And if he's in agreement?
You'll cancel the proceedings immediately.
Oh, then we can expect the whole thing to be over and done with. And
it'll be washed up within a day.
Oh, that's great, Lee. You've done a hell of a job. Well, come on, Alan. Let's order a nice fattening lunch to celebrate.
We'll be in touch.
Yes.
Bye.
Hi, Edward.
Thanks very much.
I mean...
Oh, well, you were right. That was some surprise they gave you.
I can't tell you how relieved I am to be rid of that case.
I just wonder what's going to happen now. I always told you that there was lots of feelings between Monica and Alan.
Oh, sure. Hatred, anger, rage. Whatever happens from here on in, I hope they keep us out of it.
Oh, I will drink to that.
Cheers.
Hey, it's okay to laugh to it, but I don't understand why they need my mother's maiden name on this.
Standard bank procedure.
That still makes no sense. Hi, guys! Oh, I see you've been shopping again, darling.
Yes.
Well, at least you can pay for it now.
Well, I stopped by Delphina's. I mean, I have a reason to celebrate. I think I got a job.
You got a job here, sweetheart.
Oh, yeah, but that's not. This is going to be a day job over at the corner maid.
Oh, congratulations.
Oh, well, before you get excited, let me tell you, you haven't got much to celebrate. I know I've worked for that mob before.
Well, what do you mean?
What I mean is don't accept any money till you find out what you've got to do for it.
Oh, hey. Oh, what, fired already, darling?
No, I'm on assignment, an interview with George Durnley.
Hey, listen, you be careful, babe. That guy's noted for breaking arms that don't bend his way.
Oh, keep that in mind and be very careful.
Oh, Robert. I'm so glad you're here. I need to talk to you.
Sure. Come on, out of here. Excuse us, girls.
Okay. Here, right here. Thanks, darling. Look.
What's up?
The strangest things have been happening at my apartment. I mean, I've been getting strange phone calls, radios blaring, pipes banging, and then there was a strange man lurking in the hallway.
You think it's more of this Malkuth business?
Well, could it be?
No. Now, highly unlikely. I mean, WSB were very thorough. And in any event, even if they miss somebody, I mean, why would they want to bother you? I mean, the sword and the helmet are well back in Malkuth by now.
Oh, that's a relief.
Yeah, but it still doesn't explain these occurrences of yours.
You're right. It was not the men from Malkuth.
Yes, and it could be something new. I'll walk you home just in case, all right?
Thanks. I appreciate that, Robert.
All right, sports fans, listen, hold down the boat and don't let it sink any lower. I'll be back later, all right?
Bye.
Bye, darling.
I wonder what all that was about.
Well, I wouldn't worry, darling. Ruby's not Robert's type.
Huge.
Well, that's just a coincidence.
More than you may realize. I was going to call you as soon as we finished here. Confirm the Quartermain divorce is off.
What are you talking about? I have a small fortune riding on that case.
Well, obviously you haven't heard that. You had a small fortune riding on. From what I hear, all bets are off, Scott.
Get to the point. What are you talking about?
Marital relations between Alan and Monica have resumed.
That's ridiculous.
Not according to Alan.
In order for marital relations to continue, Alan and Monica would have to...
They did, huh? Scotty, they did.
I don't believe it.
It's true, Scotty. They even have a witness.
Any clever lawyer, it shouldn't take him long to realize the pointlessness of carrying on with this divorce action.
Not necessarily.
Oh, come off it, Scott.
I am going to confer with my client. As they say, the ball game is not over until the final inning has been played.
You don't seriously intend to continue with this farce, do you?
I stand to make a lot of money in this enterprise. I wouldn't call it a farce.
Oh, that's it. The happiness of your client is of no consideration at all. All you care about is the money,
that's
is that
exactly
right?
That's exactly it. You've got the point right there. Now I'll talk to Monica, and then I will talk to you. Goodbye.
It never ends, does it?
Oh, I wasn't drinking, Robert.
You told me you were...
Hey!
Hey, easy, baby, easy. You okay?
Yeah, I guess. Thank you.
Everything working?
Oh, the ankle.
Twisted.
Oh, just a light one. It doesn't hurt enough to be broken. How'd I slip?
Just sit here a second. Not going anywhere.
Yeah, I'll get the floor. Interesting. Hey!
What? What we got here? Silicone.
What?
This is no accident. Somebody spread silicone all over the floor and up the stairs.
Well, I thought this was stuff.
Yeah,
you know.
It's got a range of uses.
Oh, yeah, with a little help. Oops.
Do you realize what would have happened if you were living on the top floor?
Yes,
I know. You ever see the scene out of Psycho, the stairway bit where they all come tumbling down?
Thanks a lot.
See if you might get the door.
Yeah, sure.
Give us your keys.
Okay, darling.
Oops.
All right, thanks. Should have lost 10 more pounds.
Indeed. Oh, well, not really. Don't mean to be.
Okay.
Yeah, his couch is just here.
Oh, boy. Looks very good.
Sit down.
Thanks, love.
Something, something. Well, the thrilling's not too bad. It shouldn't worry you.
Oh, no, nothing to it. Somebody's got silicone on the stairs trying to kill me.
Not just you, love. Where's the marsh? Back here?
Yeah.
You see, anybody could have taken a tumble on those stairs. Not just you, love. Silicone isn't terribly selective. Just keep that there. It should keep it intact.
Okay. What about you, love?
Well, I better go out there and wash down those stairs. Then I want to have a talk to some tenants to see whether they're experiencing similar problems. After that, I said I'd have dinner with Jackie at the Rib. But look, I'll call you. Now, are you okay to be alone?
Oh, yeah, I'm fine. I'll tell you something. I desperately need a nap.
I'll call you later.
Thank you, Robert.
Just filling in for a friend in the wilderness.
You're a good friend.
You know, I keep on telling him that, but he never seems to appreciate it.
He appreciates it.
How can you tell?
Because you're crazy. Luke likes crazy friends. It reminds him of himself.
Yes, I got a few things to learn about the trail, huh?
Just remember, compass, a good woman, snake oil, and a safety pin will take you around the world.
Why a safety pin?
Well, you can string a line on and catch a fish, son. Better than chomping on beef jerky.
Here, chew one of Aunt Sudie's meatloaf sandwiches. Oh. You have to keep up your strength.
Thanks.
Ready to roll, Clam?
Sure I am, Sudie. Enjoyed the visit, young fella.
Well, thank you, sir. I enjoyed it, too.
Take it easy on them tender feet.
Oh, well. Thank you, sir.
Bye.
Good night.
You on your way home to marinate your lamb chops?
Oh, Scotty, good night.
Monica.
What?
I'd like to talk to you.
What? All right.
Over here. Are you crazy? Are you out of your mind sleeping with Alan? What got into you?
How did you find out?
From the opposing side's attorney. Do you realize that you just blew any chance of a favorable settlement?
I was going to. I tried to call you this morning.
Well, why didn't you call me last night when you had the urge?
Scotty, my sex life is none of your business.
It is my business when I have a percentage of the settlement. Whether you know it or not, Lee wants to cancel the hearing now.
Well, you simply tell Lee that we have no intention of canceling anything.
I can't do that, Monica, unless you tell me this didn't happen.
Well, it did happen.
Lee says that there was a witness.
Yes, Stella's us.
Oh, that's nice. Did she learn anything?
Oh, you smart-mouth me, Scotty Baldwin. You are my lawyer. And if you intend to stay my lawyer, you are going to show me some respect.
Well, I'm sorry, Monica, but right now I don't think you really need a lawyer.
What are you telling me? We can't start over again?
Oh, yeah, we can start over again, but it's a very weak case and a very small property settlement. Unless we can prove that Alan is lying.
Scotty, I told you there was a witness, Stella.
Monica, everybody has their price.
Not Stella.
Well, you better start talking to her if you want this divorce.
It isn't going to be easy.
Well, you don't have any choice. Now, come on, we're going to go have dinner. We're going to talk about the strategy. Let's go.
Oh, nurse, go ahead and fill it all the way up. I'm celebrating.
Well, I'm sorry to keep you waiting.
Oh, quite all right. I really enjoy drinking alone.
Yeah, that's a bad habit.
How's Ruby?
Well, despite the fact that I disturbed her in the middle of a nap, she's okay. No more strange occurrences and no more weird people.
You know, I was thinking maybe you and I should go over there, especially now that Luke's out of town.
She's fine.
Still, we can't just forget about all this that's been happening.
Hey, look. Now relax, will you? Ruby's in great shape. No more weird, disturbing, whatever you call it, going on. And besides, this is our evening.
and out evening. Got it.
Got it. But really, I don't have a choice, do I?
None at all, Nat. Be a good girl and drink up your wine.
Yes, sir. Now, if you think just because I've had a couple of glasses of wine...
Oh, wait a minute, wait a minute. I never kiss on a first date.
Really?
Yeah, I just go straight past that to the most important thing. Pity your editor can't see you now.
Thank goodness he can't see me right now.
Yes, we wouldn't want him seeing more of Jackie's vulnerable side. Interesting how a lot more of that has been coming out of late. Now, were you a little embarrassed?
Maybe a little.
Sorry. But I was thinking today, you know, what would have happened if you hadn't gotten that job and decided to get back to New York?
I guess you would have had to make a choice. Stay or follow.
Don't know whether I'm up to making decisions like that.
Well, I'm glad to say that you don't have to.
I'm glad too.